The End of the Effing World Season 1 has highly minimalistic and efficient writing. Its short 8 episodes make it an accessible case study for the use of philosophical conflict, character arcs, and story structure across multiple episodes. The show tells the story of James, a 17-year-old boy who, since a young age, believes he is a psychopath. In an attempt to follow his bizarre aspiration, he sets off to kill a human being.
Alyssa was new. She'd started that term. I thought she could be interesting to kill.
The target is Alyssa, a troubled girl with parental issues. When James gets closer to her, she invites him to run away with her from their terrible homes. The two form an unlikely bond that gets tested as they meet real-life psychopaths along their escape and as the authorities hunt the two down. Today, I want to look at how The End of the Effing World sets up an efficient pilot, creates a progressive arc for James through its middle episodes, and ends with a meaningful conclusion through its finale. This is why you should study The End of the Effing World. In my video, Building a TV Series, The Pilot, I talk about how the pilot episode must introduce the philosophical conflict of the show while telling a complete narrative of its own. Within its first few minutes, the pilot of The End of the Effing World clearly establishes to its audience that the show deals with the philosophical conflict of expression versus repression. James believes that repressing his emotions is the way to live life. He believes that shaping his life like that of a psychopath is natural and healthy to his state of being.
When I was 9, he bought a deep fat fryer. One day, I put my hand in it. I wanted to make myself feel something.
Alyssa, on the other hand, believes that expression is the way to live, constantly being dictated by her heart. On one hand, that leads to her being spontaneous and carefree. On the other hand, it makes her irrational and prone to having numerous anger issues and breakdowns.
Is this from you?
What?
I'm literally here.
It's free.
Thus, when the two of them interact, belief-based conflict is immediately created. James is forced to step out of his comfort zone of numbness and feel things that he has never felt before. Alyssa is forced to grow more emotionally intelligent, as the highly dangerous situation she is put in by James does not allow for constant mental breakdowns. Having established what the philosophical conflict of the show will be like, the pilot can tell a self-contained story using said philosophical conflict by following a clear story circle. The pilot tells the story of James and Alyssa's encounter and uses their conflicting beliefs to tell a complete narrative. We start with a character in a zone of comfort. This is James, a 17-year-old boy who believes he is a psychopath.
I'm James. I'm 17. And I'm pretty sure I'm a psychopath.
But they want something. James wants to follow through in his belief of repression. He aspires to achieve a goal that will prove his belief. James wants to kill a human being. They enter an unfamiliar situation. James meets Alyssa, a perfect target for his planned murder. They adapt to the unfamiliar situation. James pretends to date Alyssa with the intention to lead her closer to him so he can kill her. Here, James pretends to play along with Alyssa's beliefs and goes on multiple dates with her, getting to know her a little more.
Are you waiting for me?
So I pretended to fall in love with her.
James gets what he wants when he creates enough of an intimate connection with Alyssa. She invites herself over to his house. James has prepared his knife and has now cornered Alyssa for her murder. Alyssa interrupts James's chance to kill her with a proposal. She says she wants to leave the town for good and that James should come with her.
Let's get out of here.
What?
I'm serious. Let's leave this shithole town now.
I figured I wasn't in a rush.
Yeah, right.
The number six in the story circle of the pilot is an irrevocable story moment. It is a heavy price that spirals the pilot in a new direction that will be followed by the rest of the series. Now James can no longer turn back. If he says no, he will miss his chance of killing Alyssa. If he says yes, he will have an even better chance of hiding her body. The character returns to a new status quo. James accepts Alyssa's offer to run away. He punches his dad in the face, steals his car, and they drive off into a new beginning. James's beliefs remain unchanged in order to be challenged in future episodes. In just 18 minutes, the show has established its philosophical conflict, its characters' beliefs, told a satisfying narrative, and established what future episodes will be like. When writing your pilot episode, keep it simple. You just have to get two things down. One, clarifying what the show is about on a philosophical level. And second, telling a satisfying and self-contained narrative that kicks off the events of the show. In my video, Building a TV Series Character Arcs, I talk about how the goal of the middle episodes of your show, in between the pilot and the finale, is to continuously challenge the beliefs of your character. This way, you can have a series of mini-stories that feed into your protagonist's arc. In the entirety of the following six episodes of The End of the Effing World, James's beliefs of repression are challenged. With every episode, James moves further away from the worldview of repression and ever so close to that of expression. In episode 2, Alyssa and James's car breaks down and they get a ride by a mysterious man. They later figure out he is a pedophile who tries to take advantage of James. Alyssa sees this and stands up for James, cornering the pedophile and telling him what he's doing is wrong. This challenges James's beliefs. There are people that care for him. And through Alyssa's expression of rage, she was able to protect him. This makes James delay his murder of Alyssa a little longer. In episode 3, James and Alyssa break into a fancy house by the road that has been left empty. James discovers the owner of the house, Clive, is a deranged rapist who videotapes his victims. When Clive returns home earlier than expected and tries to force himself on Alyssa, James acts with an instinct and saves her. Instead of murdering Clive to emotionally numb himself, he instinctively does so out of his feelings for Alyssa. In episode 4, James and Alyssa are on the run from a murder. Having witnessed what James is capable of doing, Alyssa is afraid of him.
Alyssa,
I don't want to hold your hand.
The only person that likes him is now afraid of him. James experiences firsthand the cost of being a psychopath. In episode 5, James comes to accept he has been numbing his emotions in order to repress the memories of the day his mom committed suicide. This is his ghost, the event that created his beliefs. More than that, this is when it clicks that Alyssa has become the new woman in his life to fill that caring role.
Unless you got someone else who can look after you.
In episode 6, the police close in on them, hunting them down for the murder James committed. Because of his psychotic actions, James has not only endangered himself, but the one girl he likes. This is the cost of having the life of a murderer that he wished to have. In episode 7, they meet with Alyssa's dad, who is as aloof and emotionally distant as James wishes he could have been. James is able to see the negative consequences of that type of attitude firsthand. Alyssa's dad is manipulative, avoidant to his problems, and a terrible father to her.
Is he your dad?
Oh man, this is too much. This is like some kind of fucking ambush or something. I'm going home.
All of the middle episodes serve as a series of stepping stones for James's change towards expression, each being bigger than the one that came before. When outlining the middle of your season, don't merely focus on interesting or fun adventures your characters can go through. Focus on how you can continuously challenge your protagonist's beliefs through a series of self-contained stories. use these self-contained stories as stepping stones for their character arc, bringing them further away from belief A and closer to belief B. In my video, Building a TV Series Endings, I explain how a show's finale is the points 5, 6, 7, and 8 of the story circle of the entire show. In addition to completing its structure, the finale is when the story must reach its philosophical conclusion. The End of the Effing World had one of the most talked about endings at the time of its release because of its structural and philosophical conclusions. Structurally, the finale works because it ties the remaining beats in the show's story. James realizes he no longer wants to murder someone. He has felt things with Alyssa he has never felt before. After a long time, James has found happiness. He and Alyssa plan to steal her father's boat and live together somewhere far away.
We should go away, properly away, like somewhere foreign.
Yeah.
Do you want to do that too?
Yes. I really did want that.
But James pays a heavy price. Alyssa's father calls the cops, declaring their location in order to get a reward. And as James has just turned 18, they are allowed to incarcerate him or even take him out. The cops arrive and invade the house looking for James.
You actually in the police? Yes.
Can you stop pointing at me, please?
James forces Alyssa to stay behind, protecting her. James runs. He runs as the police prepare to shoot him down, accepting his fate. At this moment, James changes. James no longer sees himself as a psychopath. Instead, he is willing to die for love.
I've just turned 18. And I think I understand what people mean to each other.
By completing the story structurally, the show also completes itself philosophically. James changes from a person who believed he should repress his feelings to a person who is expressing his feelings so openly that he is willing to die for love. And it is from this philosophical climax that we can derive the message. Through its conclusion, the show says that although expressing oneself might be painful and can lead to tragedy, it is the only way to live. When creating a finale, keep it simple. Focus on two things. 1. Finish points 5, 6, 7, and 8 of the show's story. 2. Reach a final thesis on the philosophical conflict. One of the two competing beliefs must prevail. And from there, the audience will derive your message. The End of the Effing World perfectly captures the pain and excitement that comes with being a teenager through highly minimalistic and efficient writing. The show may not be perfect, with heavy reliance on voiceover to get exposition across and a rather sluggish midpoint, but despite that, there is still much you can learn from it in terms of the fundamentals of screenwriting. You can learn how to create an efficient pilot episode, develop a progressive arc for your protagonist throughout your middle episodes, and end it all with a meaningful finale. Screenwriters, are you interested in identifying your script's major problems, solving them all, and working with me to easily rewrite your script in 60 to 90 days? If so, click the link below and book a call to discuss it with me. This video was written by Alberto Hallfeld, a member of the Practical Screenwriting team.